A tech stock retreat, dragging down the major indexes on Wall Street Thursday. Let's get a read of the markets from Terence Gabriel. He's Stocks Buzz Analyst at Thomson Reuters. Welcome back, Terence.
Thank you.
Terence, retail sales unexpectedly rose in August, yet why are the markets down? Was it too much of a good thing?
Perhaps so. Retail sales did surprise to the upside, and that's even with Hurricane Ida, concerns over the Delta variant, perhaps some boost, of course, from back to school shopping could have been in there. But at the same time, we saw the market react to it positively initially in pre-market and with the open for the most part. But once again, the gains quickly faded and the market came under pressure.
And why is that?
Well, it may well be because good economic news to a certain extent does raise concerns over the Fed and how aggressive they would be in terms of tapering their stimulus. Although it's sort of out there in the market that there's an expectation that this is going to happen before year end in terms of them kicking off the tapering. Nevertheless, valuations are stretched and the market is at a high perch, and therefore any such concerns about a reduction in liquidity are going to be an issue for the market.
Indeed, Treasury yields did rise, and that seems to be pressuring tech stocks, pressuring the indexes. What do you see in terms of technical indicators, and what do they tell you about the momentum and where this market is headed?
Well, actually, when we look at a number of breadth momentum measures or market internal measures, say based on advancing and declining issues, we see that those indicators are showing a lot of weakness. And that deteriorating breadth is a great concern for a lot of traders, especially when, again, when you have the market really sort of flirting with all-time highs, but yet you've got sort of the great mass of stocks really not participating in that push. And that kind of bad breath is something that is a worry and does lead us to sort of look at the market in terms of once it's now started to roll over, the issue is that going to gain steam in the indices because we've already seen very sharp deterioration sort of in the broader market. So I think at least it does leave these indexes vulnerable to deeper declines until we start to see those market internal measures stabilize.
You get the sense that perhaps the gains for 2021 have already been achieved?
Well, that would certainly be a potential here. We saw the S&P 500 peak on September 2nd. It started to roll over. It's only down about 2% or so from that high. But of note, September has been on average the weakest month for the S&P 500 throughout the year. We look back throughout history. So perhaps it's not surprising that given the run-up we've had, the weakness has started to kick in here. I mean, also we should consider that it's been almost one full year since the S&P 500 last ended a decline of more than 5% on a closing basis. Now, that is the longest stretch of time between declines of at least 5% when we go back more than 3 years. So it did tend to suggest that the market had sort of reached a point where perhaps the easy gains were behind it. And given these considerations about how is inflation going to develop moving forward? How's growth going to develop moving forward? We've recently seen a number of investment banks sort of pull back on their GDP forecasts over the near term, and also we've got considerations with the Delta variant and how that will affect growth, and also concerns over China. So. There's sort of a number of issues all coming to roost here that are weighing on the market at lofty levels while we've seen this deteriorating technical picture underneath the surface. So it definitely does sort of suggest that the market's got an issue here with data. Very weak data calls into question growth moving forward. Again, we've got lofty valuations, which can be an issue if growth starts to deteriorate, but also stronger than expected economic data gets the market worried again that the Fed is going to taper aggressively. So it's a difficult moment for the market to be in.
Okay. Yeah, it seems as though its momentum is waning. Well, thanks a lot, Terence, for your views.
Thank you.
Our thanks to Terence Gabriel of Thomson Reuters. I'm Fred Katayama in New York. This is Reuters.